Good morning, everybody. Thanks for joining us here on the web. Officers pulled a man from a burning car after an overnight crash in Pelham. Police say 53-year-old Michael Hines of Derry was under the influence of drugs when he crashed into a tree on Windham Road just before midnight. Officers say he actually tried to go back to the car as the fire spread and the tires exploded. He now faces several charges, including DUI and possession of cocaine. A Boston man is facing charges this morning after Manchester police say he overdosed in a Dunkin' Donuts bathroom while his son was in the waiting room. Police say 26-year-old Christopher Morrissey left his 9-year-old unattended while he went into the bathroom to do heroin at the Dunkin' Donuts on Candia Road. The boy alerted a staff member when his dad did not come out after a while, and workers found Morrissey unconscious. First responders were able to revive him with Narcan. The manager of the Dunkin' Donuts says this is the second time in a matter of months that someone has overdosed in that restaurant.
I'm in recovery myself, and seeing it not getting any better affects me personally and affects, you know, me and my friends. I used in a Dunkin' Donuts restroom quite often. I had a job in Concord, and that's one of my main places I would use. So I completely understand what they're going through.
Morrissey is now charged with endangering the welfare of a child. There is a $5,000 reward this morning for information that helps track down a missing man from Kensington. 23-year-old Jacob Marsden was last seen on July 24th at the Home Depot in Seabrook. This photo was taken 20 minutes before his phone was shut off. His vehicle was found abandoned near a wooded area in Seabrook.
You're not in trouble. We all love and miss you. If anybody, I beg you, if anybody knows any information, please call the Kensington Police Department. I love you, Jacob.
Police have searched from the ground and air, but so far have not found Marsden. Several people are looking for new homes this morning after fire gutted a kitchen and heavily damaged a seven-unit apartment building on High Street in Concord. Smoke was first spotted just before 10 o'clock yesterday morning. The cause of that fire is still under investigation, and officials say a cat and a fish did die. Police officers across the country will be joining their communities tonight for the 34th annual National Night Out. The event is meant to promote stronger relationships between police and the public. This year, dozens of New Hampshire communities are hosting National Night Out festivities. For more information, you can head to natw.org. That's it for your morning webcast. We'll have an update at 1 o'clock this afternoon. Have a great day.